Alright guys, track number 5. All basic moves. Let your instructor take you on the journey in this track. Try to have a lot of fun like we always do in the number. And try to let your participants scream as loud as they can with one word. Mickey!
You know what you gotta do guys? Set up your track. Set up this number for your participants. Let them know, everyone, this is the word. When we scream, it's Mickey. So that they know what to scream instead of going, yeah, so set it up, they can have more fun with this track. Track number 6. Now, in track number 6, we've got a cutter, which is very similar to the warm-up cutter. Actually, it's almost identical. So let's get into front stance. So get into A-frame. Now, with a cutter, same as the warm-up. Sweep up through the middle, sink down, push forward. Now, with your right hand, bring it around. Now, it's the same as the warm-up, but instead of eskivering out, you're turning your whole body, and then you can come back into your guard. Now here's the sequence where we shuffle. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now instructors, if you're launching with someone, you need to remember you're working together, so everything needs to be in sync. One person on stage is great. Two people on stage is just magic, yeah? So if you're doing shuffles like this, I'll do it properly, you do it stupid. Ready? Let's go. One more. Yeah?
You see what happens.
We don't need to tell you that it looks stupid, yeah? So make sure that everything is in sync. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, here, before we do the last shuffle back, I take this opportunity to set up the next move, yeah? Jab, jab, cross. Go! And then I, cue it in. So that's what I do in my class.
That's what I do too, Tommy. It's the preview and the pre-cue. It's very, very important. All right, take the wide. The first punch of the head body cross comes to the nose. The second one, we squat down and we aim for the chest. Then guard back up, come up, and then cross out. Make sure that you stay up with the cross. Do not do something like this. Don't sink, don't sink. Stay upright. Be careful with your knees also. You have only 2. All right, we're gonna do it real speed, twice.
Yeah.
Ready? All right, head, body, cross, go. Head, body, cross. Head, body, cross. Very simple. Then we add the back kick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice strong kick, go. Bump, back and again. All right, with the back kick, you gotta make sure that your hip is in one line, straight to the front. Then look over your shoulders, and then give a back kick. Step, kick, step, back, guard up. All right, we're gonna do it again, 2 times at full speed. Ready? 4, 3, 2, go. Ba, ba, ba. Do it again. Beautiful. And make sure that your back kick stays in front. Don't do this. Because you know what Tommy does to bad instructors. Alright.
And you all know it pisses me off, yeah?
Yeah.
Do not turn your body for your back kicks.
Like, what the f- are you doing, man?
We're in Belgium! Muay Thai. Let's go. Get into your right stance. Muay Thai. Now, with your Muay Thai, we have the first sequence. 2 front knees, yeah? 1, 2. Now with your front knees, make sure they are front knees. Do not go 1, hello, 1, hello, yeah? I don't want to. Make sure that your front knees stay at the front, yeah? So they are front knees. Land, we have descend rear elbow, shoo, descend front elbow, shoo, just like that, full combo. 1, 2, 1, 1, yeah? Now when you do your elbows, lean over, and then lean over. All right, let's do it twice in real speed. Go. Yeah? Gonna join us? I love Belgium. I love Belgium. Hey, look at this top. Come here. Can I show your top here? Put your hand here. And what does that say? Tommy! Say hi, YouTube.
Hi.
Hi, YouTube.
All right, the second part is a step over cross. Very simple. Go. Step back, step back. Now, what we are going to add on is the check. It's a new move to combat, a brand new move. It's very heavy, it's very hard. Take it as an option. The first thing you need to do is just step over, hold here for a sec, then bend your arm, open your hand, push off your front leg, bring your elbow and your knee together, and protect your vital organs. Go. Take this as protection. It's like when the karate punch, what Tommy explained, keep your opponent on a distance. All right, we're gonna do it twice, real speed. Ready, go?
Let's go.
Go. All right, looking good.
Yeah.
Something more.
Now guys, it is crucial that you get the footwork right. You need to know where to put the weight in either the front leg or the back leg. So what you need to do, you need to push off the back leg, cross it. Now you land with the front leg. Now the weight is here, you push off, check, and land back, yeah? So the weight is back here now. So the weight is at the front, now the weight is at the back, yeah? You need the weight there so that you can push and push, yeah? Now, try doing it without bending your knees. Now stay up, let's go. Yeah, it's hard. Get down, now do it. The lower you are to the ground, you're literally more grounded and you can kind of push off and stay down, yeah? Real fighters stay low to the ground and they don't stay up on their tippy toes like fatties. Yeah?
All right. Track number 8 already.
Track number 8.
It's almost done. All
right, what do we do with track 8?
All right, track 8, very simple. Front stance, very simple, dukes up. We have a speed versus power sequence. Mm-hmm. Very simple, very easy, but you gotta show the difference to your participants.
Yeah.
First, take your guard up. Give me 4 fast jabs, right, left, go. Now, give me 2 power. Let them see the difference between the speed and the power. All right, Tommy, let's show them how we've seen it. Mm. Go. This don't, I hate this.
No energy, there's nothing about it.
It's f***ed up, man.
Let's show them how to, Belgium!
Beer and chocolate, dude.
All right, we're gonna show you how it's done properly. Yeah, speed versus power. Differentiate the difference between the two styles of punching, yeah? You're gonna increase your workload, you're gonna increase the calories that you burn, you're gonna get a better workout, and you look much cooler.
Yeah, man. But make sure, as an instructor, that you show all 4 levels.
Yeah.
Your participants can choose, but you need to be at the top.
Mm-hmm.
Your fitness needs to be great.
Now let's go jab, jab, single jabs, starting with the right, go. All right. Level 2! Level 3! Level 4! See, you can just go up to level 10 if you want, but what's the point if A, you're not doing it, and B, your face expression stays the same like you are in level 1? You need to express yourself, you need to show, you need to do, you need to, everything needs to be there to make a good instructor. So, level 1. Level 2, level 3, level 4, yeah! Yeah? All right, you need to go through the levels. Show them, be the role model that they want. They're paying for that class, they want an instructor. They don't want some sissy up there going, wee, wee.
What else we have in this track? We have uppercuts, a combination.
Yes. Okay, everyone, right leg forward, dukes up. Now, with your uppercuts. Now, I've seen instructors do this, and technically it's fine. They say 20 uppercuts. In the DVD, it was said this way as well. And like I said, it's fine, because essentially it is 20 uppercuts, but the difference is it's 16 uppercuts, then a combo which includes 4 uppercuts there. So it is 20 uppercuts, yes, but you need to separate the two sequences so that your participants know there are 2 separate parts, yeah? Let's go. This is how we do it. 16 uppercuts. 16, 15, 40, 30, 12, 11, 10, count with us! 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, combo! Double jab, cross, double jab, cross, yeah? So separating the two, you can cue it better. They know it's combo! Yeah, you can say combo, you can say uppers, you can say go, you can visual cues, you can do so many things if you don't do that whole 20 uppercuts as a cue.
It's much easier for you and your participants.
All right. I'm on YouTube!
Track number 9, we have our hover! Now, if you have a look here, his elbows are nicely close and it's underneath the shoulders, yeah? Back is nice and straight. The abs are braced, yeah? This is your hover position. This is the level 2, if you will. If you want to go down to level 1, you drop on your knees, but you keep the tension in your stomach, yeah? Now, we are going to show you, I say we like it's me, but it's really Roy.
But I'm doing the work.
We are going to show you how to do the Superman. Let's go. Right arm up, left leg up. Now, this does not come up here like I've seen many instructors do, yeah? You only need about 6 to 12 inches off the floor, and that's all you need, yeah? So you just want to bring some tension here, here, and here, and you know, to really benefit. Now this comes up, you're really using your back muscles, your shoulders, and it's just a great exercise. Making sure you brace your abs, because that's exactly what you're using in this exercise as well. Your abs are contracting to stop you from collapsing, if you can get my drift. Now guys, we've seen in class that people really move their hips as they're doing the Superman. That's because number one, you're not contracting your abs, or maybe you're not wide enough with your feet, or try a few different things. So if your feet are together, you might find that you won't have enough balance. If your feet are slightly out, you might find that you do have balance. So toy around with these type of techniques and see how you go, but try to keep your hips nice and straight. Show us right and left. Yep. And down. Okay, so what Roy's gonna do now is show us how to do the hover, and to show us how straight he can keep it. Alright, show us the hover. You squeezing?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Keep going.
Okay, it's good now.
April Fool.
Track number 10.
It's already done, mate.
Last track. Very simple cool down. You just, what we do in our class is we introduce each other. Now for participants, you need to do these things. So you're down, let's just say we're in our lunge position, and you go up. See, what I did, I said, guys, introducing Roy Fridge, and then everyone clapped, and then on the second one when we switch, he jumps on the mic and says,
Mr. Tommy Darmody!
Yeah, because you are putting on a show. So introduce each other. Yeah, round of applause. You're showing respect to your fellow combatter. You're showing respect to the class, to the performance, body combat. You really need to perform, and don't forget that. We are there to perform and put on a show. So keep that in mind.
And think it how it is. Les Mills, one tribe, one community. There's not much to it.
That's it, guys. It's the end. Thank you very much for watching. This is Roy. My name is Tommy. Do go down to the store and check out these tops. I've got great designs. This is the most popular one, but there are loads of designs.
Yeah, man.
So definitely go down. Check out my website, www.tommydarmody.com. Go to my website and then you'll see the store link. Click on one of the images. It'll take you straight to my store. Check out the great designs. Here's a couple of pictures of different designs that you can buy. All you need to do is simply click, bye, and then Tommy is happy.
And then we say, bye.
Bye.
and buy some shirts, man.